about myself, for example, I wouldn't exist if there hadn't been colonization. But that doesn't mean I wish it had happened in order for me to exist. That makes sense. I think it's something that happened, something that we as a continent, and I can speak for Guinea-Bissau, I know that in Guinea-Bissau we have not dealt with what colonization has done and what the war of independence has done for our people.
Okay, let me help you. Okay, just make it brief, very snaggy. Okay, we are here to discuss about histories and stories. And before colonization, we used to give stories to our next generation through the word of mouth.
Yes.
But now, here comes a person who tells you it's better write it down for the sake of your posterity. I think that's beautiful. We are able to interact with a Nigerian, a Guinea-Bissau, a Kikuyu from Kenya through a certain language. There's a new religion, how we dress, etc. The world is connected.
Yeah, I understand your point, but what I think I will say to you is that Europe too did not start off that way, right? They were hunter-gatherers, and then eventually they evolved, right? And the same thing was happening in Africa. Our evolution was interrupted by colonization.
Right.
That is evil,
correct.
Right? Yeah. We should have been allowed to evolve at our own pace, and we are not dummies. We are smart. We would have learned. We would have grown at our own pace. So I think that would be a response to you. Next question, please.
Can I actually propose that you read history and you're going to understand that Africa had the earliest civilizations in human history, and then now you can see how you need to reorient your reading, because I think you're reading the wrong stuff. I don't know who is feeding this to you, but you need to I can spend the rest of my life teaching you, educating you to understand your place in history, because you don't know it.
Thank you, Peter.